All right, so I'm here at Mozilla, which is responsible for the open source Firefox web browser. And it's also where we'll find Brendan Eich, the designer of JavaScript. Let's go in and learn more about that language. So in this class, we handle only a very restricted subset of JavaScript. For example, we don't pay very much attention, any attention, to the document object model. One question students might have is how useful it really is to focus on a subset of JavaScript or HTML. Can the skills that we'll learn in making a lexer, a parser, an interpreter for a smaller language carry over to important tasks in the real world? Brendan?
Yeah, the answer is yes. In the Mozilla work and in other browsers and on the web, you often are dealing with a subset of JavaScript. There's even a not quite subset, let's say it's a subset called JSON, which is quite popular. It's a way of describing trees of data. And it turns out that you want to parse JSON very quickly, even when it's loaded as if it were JavaScript, or even when it is evaled, passed to the eval built-in in JavaScript. And so in our implementation, we actually do a very quick subset parse if the stars and the moon are aligned for JSON, because that is such a common case. And if we can parse it as JSON, which is a subset of JavaScript, that's much more efficient. I also observed that a lot of JavaScript libraries, almost all of them with query in their name, are doing sort of compiled generated functions that are optimized to match a certain query against a document object model. And so there's code generation going on, there's some amount of partial evaluation going on, there's a subset of the language being used to construct simple matches and rules for matching trees.